It is. Okay, perfect.
Perfect.
So the story is, and you know, it's like, I love it. You know, you go to, there always might be, you know, just a hint of favoritism, you know, whichever country you go to, right? And so what's fun about this situation is that Na'Vi have had like an hour and a half to warm up, basically, because they got the PCs after Envy were done trouncing TQM.
Yes.
And Gamers 2 literally got their PCs like 15 minutes ago because they had to wait until after Fnatic Titan.
I don't see the problem here, Summer.
You don't see the problem?
No, I think you
don't see the problem here? That, you know, like, no, I don't know, Na'Vi, just a little favoritism here? Maybe, unbiased, totally, man.
You know, luck of the draw.
Hey, by the way, Na'Vi,
flip a coin.
We'll give you, like, five times, you know, the amount of time that we're going to give G2 to warm up and, you know, get ready for this important match.
So, that's how it works. This is how it works. I mean, sometimes it happens. Look, the game is live. We've got G2 on the CT side. We've got Na'Vi on the Terrace side. And we're playing Dust 2 as our first game here. Flashbang in and Seize lands a headshot on Michelele. Drops him down to 12 health. And that's not a fun way to start the game for him. But they still got to find a way to actually attack a bomb site here. We've got Rain and Michelele both covering B right now. Well, in the middle still, AZ. And it's actually shaping up to be a bit of an A hit right now with Jakim and Fox holding the bomb site and long.
Well,
this is not going to be easy.
Yeah, it's not. But we all know how good Jakim is, bro. We all know that this guy is monstrous. Oh, my sweet mother of God. Oh, Sue, will you marry me?
Okay, look, the game's on the way. Fox is looking for a way to not get sandwiched in, and it's not going to be successful. God, that's very distracting.
How do we
Jakim
do this?
Is also going to go down for you guys at home. We don't have webcam here, but they just brought in huge amounts of pizza into the room, so this is really good stuff. We've got Michelele and AZ. It's 2-on-4 right now, and the bomb is about to go down. This is a great start for a Na'Vi. Guardian will be dropped, and AC, he's got health to fight. They don't have a kit picked up, and Michelele, we could go for Cali action here, but he's going to get shot down by Edward, and now it's a 1-on-3 instead, and he's got to find a way out. Nice headshot from AC. I'm not sure it's going to be quite enough, though. They've still got two people to deal with. He's going to hand him one more headshot, please. It can't possibly be true. Got to remember the bomb timer as well. He might still do this. He needs one more headshot jumping off the side, but Edward going to shut him down for a double kill, and Na'Vi going to pick up the first round.
You can't hear it, but I'm blowing kisses at Sue and Trance
I'm
right now.
I'm quite sure the stream can actually hear.
They just brought us pizza. So
sick.
Oh my god, like land survival food. So sick, Trance, you are awesome.
Smix, all this stuff I said about you being Chinese, don't worry about it. Oh. Forget about it. I take it all back. It's gonna be Jakim actually opening up and around where they only have pistols and armor, looking for another kill, and he's gonna get it. They're all headshots with the 5-7, and that's a great way to start this round. Guardian and Seized trying to battle back, and they do get a couple of kills. They can even get the bomb down to the speed bombs. There's nothing G2 could do to stop this, but what a crazy round already.
You know what actually happened here, Anders? Is that Gamers 2 smelled the pizza? Because, you know, they obviously weren't in their room because they couldn't warm up, right? So they smelled the pizza. They're like, sorry, boys. Got to get this done quick. You know, can't waste any time. Got to get it while it's hot. Na'Vi, get out of our way. And now, Guardian. That was a little bit close. That was a little bit close. But it looks like Gamers 2, at least, they're going to get a couple of AKs.
Oh, dear God. Yeah, for those of you who are not aware, this is essentially the ghetto stream, so...
What's up?
Shot, baby! Guardian! That's incredible. He's got the scout. He's in a 1-on-2. He's got the pistol out now, and this is perfect for the amount of health that he has. He's going to go for another one. He's got the triple looking for the quad. One more bullet. He has to reload. It's close with that. Fox is coming for him. He's going to get the headshot. Guardian. Quad kill. And that's the second round. What is this madness?
I don't even know, Anders. All I know is that Guardian is very good at this game. Three kills for him, saves the round for Na'Vi and Gamers 2. They came so close, they could almost taste the pizza, and it was wrenched out of their hands by Guardian. What a monster!
That is insane. He was going to get stabbed by Fox.
Actually, can you pull the Twitch chat closer to the monitor? No, like, pull the Twitch chat, like, the monitor closer.
Oh, the monitor itself?
Yeah, just bring that.
I could probably do that.
Yeah, we got space for it. This is an anti-eco, guys, so, you know, we expect Na'Vi to, you know, crush Gamers 2. That's it, you know, if it all goes according to plan. I mean, we lose AC. Flamey drops fairly low in the process, however, so that's not too pleasant. But Zeus, you know, managing to do some work. Michelele, though? Or no, that's Jakimlele, rather.
Jakimlele.
Actually, we're just going to call them by their name. So, Rainmon. Oh, dude, he been listening to the Rice's dub. Rainmon. Rainmon. Yo, man.
I don't know. I don't know at this point. I've given up. Jay Kim should be in an easy kill here. Stealing away a little bit of a rifle. Maybe Fox could get a kill here with the UMP. It'd be great if he wants to buy an AWP later on. Instant headshot on Suicide. Didn't look like he had head armor either. The Guardian doing a good job.
And Jay Kim later gonna get caught out by C's. Nicely done by Na'Vi, stabilizing the situation. They did give up a bit more than they would have liked. Unfortunately for them, Jacob is going to be able to get a little bit more money out of that. He's up to 5 kills as well. Michael is trailing, though, with a nice fat 0. So we'll have to see if James Bond is going to make an appearance anytime soon. I doubt it. Michael's pretty damn good, but, you know, we'll see. It's always a chance.
Well, Guardian. Ooh, looked like that could have been attacked for the wall. Not quite going to be the case. Fox is on the other team with an AWP and even some grenades to spare, so it's getting a bit better. People are saying fix the HUD.
We're not getting health and ammo.
Oh.
There we are.
Pay me more. Fix that so quickly. Alright. It's got Rain up here with the M4 outside of the B-bomb site. Inside it is AC, and covering from CT spawn is Michael Lilly. So strong setup towards the B-bomb site. That sort of axiomatically leaves the A-bomb site a little bit more open. Fox is here with the AWP, Jacob down in pit. Still a pretty good deal. I'm less a fan of Fox holding this position than I am holding down here. I think this is so much more risky. That's just my opinion, and we'll see if he can make it work either way. Looks like they might be going in middle instead, which would mean that it's going to be up to Michael Lilly and Rain to set up some sort of crossfire here.
Yeah, Michael. He's falling back. He did chuck a flash in there, but yeah, it seems like he was expecting some kind of pressure over on long. He's going to be slightly out of position, and now it's all on Rain, who's very busy flashing himself. Doesn't stop him from getting the headshot on Edward, and the wall bang on Flamey, and the third on Zeus, and guess what? AC's here too. Good night, Seized. Sweet Prince, it's time to sleep with the fishes, so that James 2 can go and eat some fat pizza. Rainmon, he's got the 4K.
The whole chat is now people just saying Semler's high. We've come full circle, by the way.
What are you talking about, bro?
He is trying to eat the pizza in the meantime. It's actually impressive. You know, like part-time pizza, part-time casting.
Dude, I've got like 10 slices of pizza in front of me. How could I not attempt to eat at least one of them?
Fair enough. Well, we've got a couple of deagles in play here. One on Guardian, one on Flamey. Guardian, you know, if he had like a little bit more money here, maybe he could go for an earlier orb later on. We always have this conversation, and it's never quite clear what the logic is, or if there is one at all. Either way, it's 3-1 a scoreline. Michael Lilly not getting that shot through the doors. It looked like he was gonna, but they should be able to take care of this round fairly easily. Jacob up in that A bomb site with the Molotov to force them back.
I realize now I might have to slow down with the pizza eating, you know, because you're obviously going to hand it off to me at one point, and I can't have my mouth full of pizza.
It would be funny if I'm like, we could make that work. I think Guardian gonna go down, and if I just throw it to you in like a 1v3, you're like, oh, Guardian,
and then I end up choking. Not as hard as you know that. Never mind.
That was gonna be a Richard Lewis joke, wasn't it?
Maybe.
Seuss with about 10 health left, and Seized with about 40. They've already done much damage. Rain, the only one down to a third of his health, but the rest are going to be all right. And yeah, just a bit of a casual round here coming out. Michael Lilly doing a good job, though.
Yeah, now they're starting to get warmed up here. 3 kills for Michael Lilly. And Jacob, yeah, sitting pretty. If Jacob gets fired up, Na'Vi are going to be in for some pretty sad times. So we'll have to see what the CIS team decide to go with here. They are going to go for the force buy after all. Seas should be able to get an AK and Kevlar. Yep. And Flamey the same. Single flash. Get the flash, Flamey. Flamey, get the flash. Flamey. There's a flash. You got money for it. Flamey. Flash. I guess not.
Nope.
Okay, then. Why not get the flash, Flamey? It's not like $200 is going to make a big difference, but a flash certainly could.
Just not happening. Fox with a good kill, and I mean, it's a double up setup for the CT side and a scout for Guardian instead, so that's a bit disappointing. And he wanted to challenge in the middle, but it wasn't going to happen, so now we're playing 4-on-5, and yeah, Seized, Guardian, and Flamey need to find a way to pick up a round here.
Versus a double AWP setup. Nightmare stuff. Dude, I mean, I'm not talking about Friday the 13th. And this is going to be Michael falling back into CT. He gets that smoke down just to buy a little bit more time. Na'Vi have done a good job of clearing out Cat, though, so they have at least that to work with.
Where's that grenade? Oh.
Was that a team grenade?
No, it was from Catwalk. That was weird.
Okay, then.
Not normally a place you'd be throwing a grenade, but maybe they saw it coming.
What's interesting is they choose to double up the ops on A site rather than having one over on B, one on A, which is the default way of using a double op on Dust 2.
And it means they can push, and I think they will be pushing B and mid once again. See if they can make it work. Mykelele going to miss the shot here. They do have a smoke to block him off with, and it's going to be up right then and there. Still a Molotov in play as well if they need it. AC and Rain inside, and Mykelele can find the angle at the edge. Actually, he goes down. That's a lot of trouble for AZ. He's going to have to come up big here. 20 seconds left. Backup is coming in, but he's still going to have to do it on his own for a while, and Seize will just shut him down. Nice shot. It hit Seuss, who had the bomb, but still couldn't get the kill on him.
Yeah, what was that? Both of the players, you know, caught asleep. If they can get a quick follow-up here, Jacob, perfectly capable, spots the man on plateau, will remove Flamey instead, looking for that headshot. And that's Guardian. Guardian needs to be very careful here. He's the only one with any HP. And, you know, thanks to that bonus 5 seconds they get with the bomb defuse, they can actually make this retake happen if they were to land the shot quickly enough. There we go. Jacob, he gets the key frag, and now it's all on Zeus. He's got the AWP Zeus. He knows he's low, and it's all down to who's going to hit the shot. There's the bait! There's the shot! And Jacob, he gets the ace!
Wow. And he's going to have the time as well, just a little bit extra, and they're all asking for the health, of course. It's a really big retake coming out of G2, and that's going to give them another round, tying it up at 3-3. With Jacob currently at 12-0-3, so a pretty respectable 4-kill differential there. It's not bad.
Looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. Sorry. Rip ears. Rip ears.
Ace Lilili. Jesus Christ.
Ace Lilili?
What has Mike Lilili done to us? I don't know. It's just, at this point, whenever G2 are playing, you're apparently just allowed to add Lilili to anything and not be called an idiot. That's how it works. That's the magic. Mykelele down in the pit, and holding close by is Jacob Lily. Fox all the way up here. This game is ridiculous, isn't it?
Is that the new minigame that we're going to have here, Anders?
Please let it not be.
Okay, so Jacob Lily and Mykelele, they've got it going well, but I mean, Fox Lily's taking just a little bit of damage there on the AWP. It doesn't really matter. He's got the op, you know, so he's looking to just get that one-shot kill in. If it does come to an extended firefight, if he misses that first shot, he might be regretting taking some of that damage. What it is shaping up to be here, however, is an A split. And there we go. Michael takes the peek at Longhouse, spots out Edward. Doesn't see anybody else, though, so he can't just tell his team, you know, start rotating, but because it's still pretty early on in the round. 50 seconds. Spotting two, though, that might make a difference.
Oh, but Jacob coming into it as well. He's going to get the kill, and Michael actually ends up with a double kill. It looked like that was a pretty bad spree. Fox shutting down one, and now Guardian, well, disposing of that scout, picking up an AK instead and coming back for more. There's an unreasonable amount of targets for him to try and hit here. He's got two health as well, and looks like he's going to try back. Ironically, he could run in and put the bomb down and it'd be hard for him to stop him, but he's going to be in the middle instead.
Yeah. And Anders, we're going to have to come up with something, you know, like some kind of punishment, because you said Jacob and Fox without adding level.
I don't want to do it.
So, Foxalele will find the last kill on the Guardian.
It'll get out of control.
And, well, money's still looking pretty good here for G2. So, no real issue there. It's going to be on Na'Vi. Na'Vi really needed that bomb.
It's going to be one of those things. Getting up there. Ooh, it's going to be one of those things where we do it as a joke, and then it will be on stage tomorrow in front of, like, 15,000 people.
And we'll still do it.
And be like, he's going to throw a grenade. I can't stop it.
And we have a Pazalele coming in from Seized, but there's no reason given. We don't know if it's a tactical pause, a timeout, or if it is a technical issue, if perhaps somebody's PC has a disconnected.
Yeah, we're not being told, so
of course not.
I assume this is not a tactical timeout, because why would you do that at 4-3? Does not make a lot of sense, does it?
Well, you better just come up with a pretty good solution if you're going to go for the tact pause now. But I could see it being, you know, there could be some kind of way to make sense of that. I'm kind of curious, though, like what they would be discussing right now, considering, you know, they've gone A, they've gone B.
Do you appreciate, by the way, the magic of slowing down the forward speed?
It is a tactical timeout. So what? There we go. They're calling it. Right?
At 4-3.
Right now,
that's
at 4-3, they're calling for the tactical timeout. I don't think so, Anders.
It is.
I think that you have a little bit of time here to discuss. They're going to go into a quasi-buy, it looks like, and then they'll have a full buy. So they're probably discussing what the hell is going to go on here in the full buy.
Do you see how cool it is? You can fly around with like slow forward speed, and it doesn't like give everyone a seizure.
Are you just hitting walk? Or are you?
Yeah, I'm walking as well, but I've got the forward speed slowed down to like 200 instead of 450. So smoothing. It's so soothing, isn't it?
Still giving me motion sickness. Thank you, Anders.
Well,
this pizza's about to come back.
I was going
to
say you've
I hope it tastes good a second time.
Too much pizza. What? Okay. Apparently, we've unpaused, and now we have. I don't know. Talked about the first seven rounds, I guess.
What? I just heard Zeus.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I just heard someone talking in game.
No. Zeus, he used his push-to-talk button in game, and I heard him. So what is that about?
I don't know, but look at Rain. They don't have armor on the other team, and, well, they're just kind of sleeping outside the bomb site as well. And Rain's like, well, okay then. Going to be a couple of kills in there. Does drop pretty low, and still gets the kill on Guardian regardless. So a decent round from Rain so far.
Seized. Calmly tapping away. Zeus going in for the shot, and he gets the kill on Fox. That's an AWP dropped. We know that Zeus could make good use of it, but he's not going to have too much time. Smoke goes down, and, well, single shot will do the trick. Jacob Lilliot going to get the job done.
I'm quite sure that he thought there was a flashbang coming through, but there wasn't, so it just looked kind of ridiculous for him to, like, look at the wall for a second, like,
okay, Anders, this is it. The moment of truth. And I'm not talking about Gangstar. What are they going to do?
I don't know, because I don't even know. They hadn't even, like, tried anything, really, so I don't know why they took the tactical timeout. I think they're going to do exactly what they would have done without the tactical timeout. Just continue to try different strategies. I mean, this is a default so far, just taking control of middle with Guardian, with the AWP. So, yeah, I can't explain it.
Well, I mean, again, it's a default, straight-up default here from Na'Vi, but they must find something.
Like this.
Oh, I thought for a second there Foxalela was going to take the shot, and he did! He caught Edward, and I don't know if that was before or after the smoke cleared, but Rainalela is going to find Flamey in upper dark, and there we go. Two-man advantage here for Gamers 2, and it ain't looking too good for Na'Vi. Although Guardian, still alive, always a threat, not this time. Azalela is going to take him out.
Season Suits are left 2-4. Trying to see if they could somehow inflict more damage, maybe bring the game back, probably not. It looks like they are about to lose another round. That'll be 6 in a row, by the way, for Na'Vi. I mean, Gamers 2 were looking somewhat disappointing earlier today, right? Mm-hmm. They weren't having a good game. They weren't even like putting up much of a fight at all.
Well, Gamers 2, that was yesterday, yeah?
Oh, yeah, yesterday, sorry. Today, maybe a bit more?
Yeah, I mean, they should have had some preparation. They've had all day here to try and review what went wrong yesterday, get their heads in the game. I mean, granted, Na'Vi got more time to warm up, but Gamers 2 right now are wrecking them. And the money's starting to get a little out of control here. Rainalela and Azalela just both, you know, sitting way above 10k. That's not what Na'Vi are looking for at this point.
I hope you keep saying, like, Lele so much that your tongue cramps eventually. Just like, Anders, call for an ambulance. Jesus.
No, you just sit and laugh at me. Don't even act as if you try to help Anders.
Probably not. AZ with a good shot. Guardian actually comes back with a deal there. That looked like maybe it would have been a good double kill. That's the second time they pushed aggressively up a dark, and they actually kind of make it work. So not too bad.
Whoa, and Jake Lele! Double kill for him. Flamey and Edward both gone from long, and that drops the bomb as well for G2. So pretty much, you know, Anders, you were praising them. Na'Vi, you know, they kind of went, you know, their way. You know, it was pretty good. And then they decided to just completely and utterly throw that advantage away. Or not as I mean, I suppose, you know, if you get wrecked, you get wrecked. There's no two ways about it.
Well, Guardian looking for the counter wreck, and he is going to be shutting down AZ in that bomb sign. The only real trouble is that the bomb is all the way over here, being guarded by Mikey Lily and his teammate. See, I'm trying to get out of it, you see.
What's his teammate's name?
Not going to say it. Seuss and Guardian. I feel like I've set something in motion that I can't control any longer.
Just accept it, Anders.
Just go with
just
it.
It's like, you know, you accepted my love. Just accept the Lele as well. There's the flash. There's the spray. Michael Lele not going to get it instead. Jacob Lele is going to pull it off. Another double kill. A quad kill total. And he's up to 18-0-4 versus Na'Vi, who are in the process of digging their own graves.
Yeah, this is quickly turning into an uncomfortable situation for the regional team here. I mean, they've certainly got the home crowd with them tomorrow, but they've got to make it there.
Well, that's the funny thing, right? They will make it. Like, this match is literally sorting out seed, and that is it. Whether you go into the quarterfinals or not, both of these teams are going into the quarters. It's just, you know, who's going to face who now?
Well, that could still make a difference, couldn't it? I mean,
Considering you have, like, TQM and Fnatic waiting for you from the other side, you know, it's not going to be, pick your poison, mate. You know, you get wrecked by the Danes, you get wrecked by the Swedes, but you get wrecked either way. I mean,
Wow. You're lucky there's another crowd here, otherwise they'd be booing.
Boo. Possibly. But it wouldn't be a boo, it'd be a boo la 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 la.
I don't know if they say boo in Belarus, but you know, I guess we'll find out tomorrow. Especially if we keep this up. AC is actually in a bit of a weird angle. You see he's up on the box. That's not too common. Which is probably what he's looking for, and I kind of like the idea. The problem is, if he obviously... Oh, he's got the auto-sniper, in fact, that's really cool. I thought he had the AWP, so if he misses a shot up there, then they just peek him and he's probably dead, but Edwards still wins the fight. The auto-sniper is definitely a better idea. Rain gonna try and make his way through a lot of targets in front of him, and now they're moving closer as well. He still wins the first fight. Sprays onto the second. Zeus has gone as well, but he can't hit the third. Still good damage being put onto Edward.
Oh, Rain is disgusting. Now, well, there we go. Jacob Lele is going to step in from Upper Dark. He's roasty. He's toasty. Flame, he's living up to his name. And he's dead. So, 8-3 in Gamers 2. They reign supreme. 20 frags for Jacob Lele. But the Rain monster. Rain Lele is doing pretty damn good himself. 2-1 so far.
Yeah. I mean, killed a Frasier too, but I'm getting used to Jacob and he's 20-4. I mean... I don't really like talking to people who have a kill death ratio of less than 3.
They're below you. Whoa, okay, that's Zeus.
Oh, that's a nice shot from Fox, and he's trying to fall back. He's got some backup as well. If they try to come around that corner, Michael is there to try and help them out, and it's going to be a 4-on-4 still, but well, the money's just not here for Na'Vi. Right now, Gamers 2, they're just having a really good time.
Yeah, they're getting roasted. Unfortunately, I think Na'Vi's own flash stopped Zeus from like getting the punish on Fox. But Guardian, that's still not going to stop him from just lighting Michaelele up. So that scout coming into play was a bit of an investment. And so far, he's making it work. He gets another tag onto Fox. And guys, just stop peeking. Here is the solution to all of your problems. Or just, you know, kill the guy. Either way, Foxelele and Rainelele just doing big work over here on the A site.
Seized an Edward now. You know, they had an opportunity, especially if they would push aggressively in the middle. But now, if they go in there, AC is going to be there. And he's got the health. He's got the... armor as well to try and deal with them. Fox and Rain. Fox is very low. If they could just get the kill on one person, that'd be it, but it is not happening.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, sit down. So far, this is looking pretty dominant, Anders. We're watching Gamers 2 just trounce Na'Vi.
And what is this? I mean, I know Na'Vi have had a history of banning Dust 2, but they shouldn't be this bad on it, I feel like. I want to see more.
I don't know. I wonder, considering you're not out of the tournament if you lose, this match could be about seed. This match is about seed. Well, we're not going to go so far as to say that Na'Vi are fixing the match, but interesting.
Oh, well, I mean, that is actually always a problem with some of this, is that if Na'Vi don't care one way or the other, if they actually prefer to play the higher seed team, then who knows?
There is that to consider. It is part of the tournament. And it is part of the game. Obviously, no, guys. You know, they're all... They're all playing their hearts out right now. And, well, they are. I mean, bringing it back. 3-3. Na'Vi, so far, looking pretty steady in this round, at least. They've got the advantage. Michaelele, he's got the... yeah, there we go. That's the issue. He had the M4. He was going to go and peek it long, but Guardian was waiting for him. And that's the bomb. But we still have two M4s alive, and it's on Rainelele and AZ.
And Ace is walking up behind him here, and I'm not sure they realize he's making a lot of noise, so maybe they would have heard at some point. They haven't really heard it yet. He's going to be coming behind, but Seized is there, and timing was just perfect from Seized. Now, Rain, 1-on-3, and oh, he's going to get shut down by Flamey. So, good round. Two ops saved, and they get the round.
Yeah, and they finally break the streak. Only issue is that Gamers 2 are filthy rich, So they're going to be able to buy up everything they want. All the toys that they never got, you know, for Christmas as kids, they can get now, Anders. You wanted a SCAR 20 auto sniper rifle? You know, there you go, buddy. You wanted an AWP? Foxy Lele's got it. So double up still for Na'Vi, though. This is, it seems like whatever, you know, they're just going to stick with what worked in the last round. Nice flash from Jacob, though. That's going to open it up.
Well, Fox very aggressive on catwalk here, and he's alone. It's one of these positions where something goes south. Are you going to be able to fall back in time? Grenade out. He spots it. He's still going to stick around, and he headshots Edward, so most definitely dead.
Yeah, nice shot, but then seized. He catches Michael peeking. So that's actually going to throw a little bit of a wrench in the works here for Gamers 2. They felt, you know, uplifted. Fox, he did his job. He got the opening pick with the AWP, but then Michael had to go and get killed and just ruin it all. So Na'Vi, they've got the edge, however slight, and it really is important that Jacob Lele stays alive as long as possible here. He's the linchpin on the A site.
Fox almost looked like he was going to get that kill. Now they're moving up on catwalk, and they're clearing out a lot of this. Seuss with a perfect opening to take down Fox, and how are they going to retake this? They've got two Molotovs, right? One on AC and one on Jacob, so they could firebomb out a lot of catwalk, I guess, if they try and retake from anywhere else, but G2 will be very slow with this retake. They knew this was coming, and yet they've only moved sort of halfway across the map.
And it's over before it even starts. Guardian picks off Jacob. So they've lost control of Long. Nicely done there by AZ and Rain. But then, man, just Guardian is tired of the shenanigans. He's going to die in the end. AZ says there's two ways here, Guardian. Either you win and we end the shenanigans that way, or I kill your ass and then you don't care anymore, right? So there's the solution. Na'Vi get a fifth round on the board.
And at the moment, they're dropping quite rapidly, in, or at least Jacob is dropping quite rapidly in KD. Just 20-7.
He needs to get one frag, and you will, you know, still talk to him tonight.
Yeah, it's true. Seized and the Guardian both with the AWPs here. So, a lot of investment on Na'Vi. Their money is not that great, and G2's is even worse. Fox trying to see if he can make the peek on over. Almost gets baited then. The guy jumping in front of Guardian.
Clever play there from Na'Vi. Guardian, he came so close. Now they're going to change it up. Rain is holding close enough to Redbox, though. He's going to be able to hear it. Yeah, he hears the clicking, the click, click, click of Guardian zooming and unscoping and zooming in and unscoping and zooming in. And when is he going to hit the timing? Is he going to go for the peek, Anders? I can't stand the suspense. Guardian, is he going to give him? Nope. Not for a second. He'd give him just the tip of the barrel there for Rain to really want to go after it. But
just the tip.
No, it's not happening. Rain, he's playing so carefully right now. I'm impressed.
That must be a little bit worrying, seeing the shots coming through. Guardian is still right on the other side. See, he's taking a bit of damage. Are we going to see something here? Rain pushes in just as they leave. It almost looks like that was coordinated. But now Michael Lele with the jump. Oh, he gets shot in the face as he's jumping. A lot of damage being dished out. And, well, they're trading a lot of kills here. But Jacob looking to see if he can actually deny them that bomb. It's dropped out on catwalk. And Guardian going to go down. Flamey last alive as Edward fell to Rain, and he's not got a lot of time either. He drops, and that's three kills, I think, for Jacob. So very good job indeed.
Yeah, super solid. Super solid round. You knew, you know, Anders, it's so important, you know, when you guys have those conversations at night. You know, you tuck him in, and yeah, if you weren't talking to him, man, I just don't think he could have handled it. So 23-0-7 for Jacob at the end of the half. Not
it's
too right. bad.
It's acceptable.
It's acceptable. 15-2-8 as well from Rain. AZ. I mean, everybody seems to be really, you know, doing their job right now. Michael, however,
I'm not talking to any of these people.
But then I'm wondering right now, because Gamers 2, one thing that they also are doing is that they're changing up the leader like almost every map. So
really?
Yeah. So it's like maybe Michael went back to calling, and that's why he's having a little bit of a tough time just, you know,
like
focusing with the frags.
A Virtus Pro type thing?
What was it? The first game yesterday, you know, they lost the first map or something, and they changed it back to Rain. So, I mean, like, they're doing that, where it's just like different people are calling different maps, it seems.
It's a real shame, in my opinion, the VP on here. I'm just saying.
This would have been a crazy tournament. But now at least they're going to keep us, you know, waiting with bated breath for DreamHack Leipzig next week.
That is true. Mm-hmm. We've got that coming up as well. We are waiting a sound issue in the meantime. If you are just joining us, then big welcome to the stream, of course. I'm here with Semler. We are on the official Ghetto stream where we have to do sort of our own production and also spectate the game ourselves and everything else. And as a result, we've gone slightly crazy. So don't worry about that.
Why does Jacob have a picture of Cadian as his avatar?
Jacob.
Yeah, look at that.
I don't think that's Cadian.
That is not Jacob, though.
No, I'm struggling to figure out what am I seeing in the background of that picture.
That's what I was wondering as well. It kind of looks like you're in a sauna. You got a towel down around your ankles, and yet you're doing a selfie. Like, how does that work?
It to me, that looks like the towel is more like down around his ass, and that's like.
Damn, dude, the guy's been working his back. If he's got that kind of, like, what, that gap along his spine?
Let's not analyze this too much, actually, but I'm just saying that was the immediate, thought that, you know, I had.
That's not Mike Lilly. People are saying that it's Mike Lilly. I don't believe you.
So it's definitely not Mike Lilly, is it?
Is it Mike Lilly?
Ass Lilly.
Get out of here.
I don't know. Look, honestly, with this team, like, I don't know how much you guys know about these people. They're all crazy. Like, if you listen to them talk to each other, like, internally, they're all nuts. So
I think the word is batshit.
Yeah. This is definitely, like, one of the most nutty teams we have right now.
Yeah.
All right. It's 10-5 for the first half score. Big victory for G2. I would consider the underdogs in this particular matchup. And yes, it's a best of three, so it's too soon to tell. But right now, they're doing a very good job.
I think Na'Vi perhaps got just a little overconfident on just how good they are on D2. I mean, they are usually very good on D2. Let's not take that away from them. But then they just, you know, get double tapped to the face. Double headshots. Guardian finally decides to step in here, do a little bit of damage, try to bring it back. But he's losing teammates left and right.
Yeah, it's just not working out so well. Now they're focused on fighting Jakim in the middle. Seuss is here as well, and they're going to get that kill, but Bomb is going to be going down any second now. And they're still fighting a 2-on-3. They don't currently have a kit picked up. They're both going to go up a dark, try and see if they can stop this. But look how, look, they're so ready for it as well. This is not cool.
Girl, this is, okay, shot window. There we go, Seuss waking up. Feeling the heat, he's gonna go in, but he gets snuffed. And AZ and Fox will pick up the last two kills. You kind of get your hopes up for a moment there. He had the right idea. He knew that the guy was up on car. It seems he was pre-aiming it, but then AZ was like, "Enough of that, Seuss. I render you mortal. Or I make you mortal." What do mortals do, Anders?
Masturbate.
Apart from that, what are the two things that all mortals do that you know that they will do?
Die eventually.
And masturbate, yes.
Okay, good. Oh, nice shot from Guardian. Instant headshot. They did go for a double scout setup. Edward can't pick up the kill with the Deagle. That would have been perfect, though. It's going to be 4-on-3, so see if they can find a way out of this one here now. It would be great if they could bring it back. They're very far behind at this point in the game. They need to step it up. Otherwise, they're going to not just lose the first map. They won't even have a chance on the first map. They'll just be swept off the map, essentially.
Dumpstered. But it's all right, you know, because TQM, you know, they've got a lot of space. It's not a concern. Seized. He's not interested in rooming, you know, even if Device is one handsome devil. He's not interested in rooming with them, so he's going to just fight to the bitter end here with the scout. If he can survive the round and hold on to this scout, it's going to be useful in the next one, but this all comes down to just how much Gamers 2 want to invest in the hunt, because they have three rifles. They don't want to lose these three rifles. They need to keep these guys alive. That's a big investment. So, yeah, we'll see.
Definitely not a lot of money. I mean, maybe Fox could go hunting. Fox hunting. well, it's going to be Mike Lilly. Just a leg shot there from Seized. Looking a little bit disappointed in himself. 12-5 and moving into the 18th round. It's just another four rounds here for G2 before they can start to move into the next map. Do you think Na'Vi can bring it back here? I'm not feeling it, Samba. I'm not feeling it.
Listen, Anders, you never lose faith in God. And God happens to be on the server in the form of Guardian.
I was going to say Seuss, all right. Fair enough.
That would be a bit on the nose. You know, that's a little odd. A little obvious, Anders. Come on, man.
All right. Well, Seuss is trying to see if he can make this work, and he's got the one kill, and Seuss actually pick up a double, so it's still a 1-on-2 here. Jakim alive with a Mac 10 and a lot more equipment than they've got on the Na'Vi side, and problem is, without the body armor, this Mac 10 is quite a good weapon. It'll aim punch them. He's getting shot in the back door, and Flamey picking it up with a double, and Na'Vi win a round that they definitely shouldn't have.
And Guardian is a generous god. He decides not to take any frags this round, feeling that, you know, his teammates needed a little support, some confidence.
He will take the AWP, though, that someone bought for him. Just saying.
You got to make an offering every now and again, Anders. Come on. You know how it works. He's a fickle one at the same time. He can be generous, but he can be fickle. You know, he's an all-around, you know, interesting guy. You never know what you're going to get, right? Is it locusts or, you know, bountiful harvests? Lots of dead? I don't know. You know, Guardian's a mystery. What's also a mystery is whether Na'Vi will be able to run this back, and we're all here together to find out. So welcome to the stream if you're just tuning in. This is the first map between Na'Vi and Gamers 2, and Na'Vi have finally got a bye.
A nice smoke that lands right in those double doors from CT Spawn, more or less. That wasn't possible always, but they removed some of the skyboxes, so now you can do it. It's a nice way to just help out whoever is holding long. This feels like it's going to be a bit of a split. Smoke goes up into CT Spawn. Seuss trying to see if he can find a way to look over it, and he's got a bit of backup and seized up here, doing some good damage, but taking just a little bit more, and this is now going to turn into a big problem. Flamey with a good headshot, Guardian helping out as well. G2, they're running into a brick wall here at the B bomb site. Rain, and actually AC there, sorry, coming up with a double kill. It's a 2-on-2.
Zeus got hit so hard he actually got ejected from the server. And now, whoa, it's getting a little bit hot there for AZ, but he's going to be able to back off. The question is whether Fox turns to his demise. Guardian with the jump, P250 headshot. Fox is there with the shot. And oh no! It just so happens that people can come from Upper Dark, Fox. And Edward was there waiting for you. So, Na'Vi will get a 7th round. And Fox, much to his dismay, well, he got one kill, Anders. But then he tried to go and hug Edward, and Edward was just not interested.
Oh, definitely not. That's a bit of a shame. I mean, the timing worked out so bad for him then. Not much he could really do. He's going to bring it to 12-7. Are you starting to feel it? Double up set up on the Na'Vi side. G2 out of money. Yes.
Yes, no, maybe so. We all know how powerful it is. I mean, Seized is a competent opper. Put him over on the B side. Get him at the back plateau. Let him hold on to it. They play a more standard, you know, they have a more standard approach, Na'Vi, to the double op. Put their B player with one, Guardian over on the A site. It can be just a little bit predictable, you know, so if G2, well, who am I kidding? G2, you know, they don't have anything prepared, but maybe they can hit some headshots and break it that way, but Na'Vi, at least, you know, we'll see. I think that they can run it back, absolutely.
That's a very good counter grenade coming out there from Seuss. No armor on the two people. They took like a combined 180 damage then. Seized going to be taking down Jacob, and well, 12-8. No bomb plant that round. They still have money. And Na'Vi, I don't know. They are bringing it back here.
And they can start getting momentum going. Just like, let's see. I mean, we had a huge streak for G2. Na'Vi are perfectly capable of doing the same, especially if Guardian starts to feel it. I mean, he is still leading. 16 frags. Seiz is right behind him. Those are the two off guys. And who is that?
I have no idea.
It's got to be... It's got to be Kadian. Just saying. Kadian gets around.
I don't want to know.
For a skinny Dane. He looks malnourished, but boy.
Oh, man. Seuss and Guardian deciding to find out what's happening long. Flash is coming around the corner from us. He's got three people on long. Seuss, he can't see a thing. Flame is here as well. He goes down. And now... Might see one of those classic Guardian moments. He is going to have to go mad at this point in time. He's got the AWPR, but he can't see Michael Elliott down there. Now they're getting too close. He gets a kill, but he goes down and sees can't stop it.
Yeah, that's where they just go ham. Get in there. Move as a unit, essentially, and that's really the only thing. You know, no fear. Even if you're the first man in, you die. Guardian's probably... He's almost always going to take one player with him. It doesn't matter if there's a man right behind him to get the refrag. AZ is waiting for Seized, and unfortunately, Na'Vi, we cursed the Manders when we started to believe that the comeback was real, that they would make it happen. They just get run over. And G2, they are not interested in letting a streak develop here. So we're going to have Na'Vi going up to, they're going to sit at 8. They're going to have to spend all of their bank, and this is the Hail Mary. This is it. Because if they lose this round, they don't have an impact in it. They are going to be at map point for G2.
It's very much true, but Guardian not afraid to take the fight early on anyway. And as they leave middle, Seized is going to be walking in here, looking in lower dark. And yeah, Jacob will have probably been told that Guardian was down there peeking, which means he's not going to think that there's a second player there. actually in Lower Dark. So that's a very nice mind game coming at Navia. It's actually very smart. I like seeing that.
Spotting so many players mid as well is actually going to work out nicely for Seized. Makes him think, okay, don't have to worry so much about Upper Dark. AZ will find a shot on Guardian, though. Never thought I'd say that. With an AWP, no less. These crazy Danes, but it is still a man advantage here for Na'Vi. So the one thing that G2 have got going for them is that they have all the nades, and Na'Vi have none. So if they're smart here, G2, they should be able to create an opening for themselves.
Seize, though. He's getting a lot of information. Seuss also pushing in, and looks like he's going to catch Maikilele with the bomb as well. That kind of put an end to it. I mean, they still got 50 seconds, and it's a 2-on-3. It's possible, but unlikely.
The timing for Seuss to push and catch Maikilele with the nade. Brutal. Just brutal. There I go. And as I say, you know, these nades, they were treacherous nades. They were supposed to be there to help G2, but instead they got G2 killed.
That actually happens a lot. I bet every matchmaking player ever has had this feeling that every time you pull out a grenade to throw somewhere, someone peeks the corner.
Yep. Exactly, man. That timing is brutal.
Wasn't there a stat someone was throwing around that Nico had like zero grenade kills in 2015?
That was Lurpus. Yeah, he tweeted that not too long ago. Out of 2015, all the lands, and he has zero nade kills, zero HE kills. Talk about like ineffective. Maybe, however, the thing is, maybe he had no kills, but he had like huge assists. Like all of his assists are actually nade kills.
I just think he's not the type of person who keeps pulling out nades to die all the time.
Yeah, he's the guy.
I think it's
who just
actually
gets,
like
more
an
of a direct
efficiency thing.
Player, you know, he's not so subtle, banking nades, that sort of thing. He's very much just like crosshair, head, pull trigger.
I swear it sounded for a minute like someone was strangling a cat outside.
I'm pretty sure that was the Industrial Funk being played again.
Industrial Funk. They were doing an in-house test of the audio here, by the way, earlier, guys. And the bass in this place is insane. It was good.
Yeah.
Really good. You can look forward to that tomorrow. Especially if you're listening in and you actually happen to be sort of going to the event this year. But even at home, I bet you can probably feel it. Maikilele down to 7 health from a great double grenade. Guardian opening up with a shot as well, taking down Rain. And things are off to a good start here for the Na'Vi team. And they've closed the gap a fair bit, down to just a 3-round difference between the two teams right now.
Indeed. Indeed, Anders. There's the bait shot, and Guardian is just like, ah, look at me, you got me, right? Flamey's there like, nah, brah. Get off my opera.
Jesus.
Seized, though, he's waiting with his own op. We might have two ops waiting over here on the site. This could get fun. No, Flamey's going to head over there. Rifle, op, and Fox just crouches in and owns Seized.
I mean, so 1-on-3 here, and Maikilele looking for an opening. Not going to get it. It's like Guardian with the triple kill, and I'm thinking Semla might not be the only person on stream who's stoned, because it looked like Seize was falling asleep there. Like, he was aimed there, and it's not like Guardian was doing, like, a sick peek in. It's more like he was crouching in and like, oh, let me see what's in this. Oh, Seize is there. Let me shoot him.
Yeah, Seize. What's up, bro?
25th round, and the gap is now down to just 2 rounds here between G2 and Na'Vi, and it's Guardian with another opening kill for this AWP. He's got someone trapped in that corner, and G2 just don't have the money. Fox actually gets hit by that AWP shot. Guardian not afraid to hold close to the middle, even with those pistols on the other side. He knows he can get back if he needs to.
Yeah, he knows what's up as well. See him just kind of like daring, you know, daring them to come through and rush him, and well, he's going to get punished because Jacob Lele, despite having some good air control there, making himself a harder target to hit, he will find Guardian in the end. Shouldn't be a problem, though. They should be able to save both ops. Yep, they do. So, economic issue, not so much. And what are we RF screenshotting, bro?
It was like one of those paint me like one of your French girls moment. You know, he was like with his elbow on the side. I had to get that. So, become a habit, screenshotting weird things. Got 29 kills for Jacob. It must be a 30 bomb for him in this game, surely. Still some distance to go. Fox is going to go down. Guardian, I think that's 3 or 4 rounds in a row now where he's got the opening frag with that AWP. It shows you just why he's such a valuable player on this team. And, I mean, that's a scary sight for G2. They need to close out this game before Guardian puts an end to them.
Yeah, this is where the pressure really starts to mount. Another little HE, completely ineffective. Going through, doing zero damage. Fantastic work there, Flamey. Just pull the trigger, Flamey. That's all. That's all you need to focus on. Just, you know, crosshair, head, headshot. Three steps, easy steps for you to for you to win. What does War All do? You don't get
do
like,
you
crouch.
Even know what you're saying anymore, Sam?
Crouch, scope, you know, flick fire, or whatever the hell it is. I don't know. It's just like for Flamey, it's simple. It's actually like two steps. You know, it's like headshot, toggle. No, we're not going that
far. Oh my god. Pistol is out and seized. Oh, looking for the edge here. He's already got the one good kill in, and AC is going to be gone as well. So, and nobody even dies for now. We're back at 13-13. They've won five rounds in a row, and G2, they don't know what to do anymore.
You know, actually, what's fun is there is a little bit of history here. You know, the toggle joke, right? Because Michael Lele, way back when, accused Flamey of hacking and raged so hard that they failed to qualify for the major because of it. Do you remember that? When him and Delpan were raising their tits off, like thinking, you know, like, oh, this guy's a hacker, why are we playing against him? Oh, no. And then, like, actually, Flamey was just that good. He just wrecked you, you know, like, shut up.
That was when they were in ESG.
That's right.
They were playing on Train.
And it was Mirage. No, it was Mirage that they raged on so hard.
No,
remember?
they raged on Train as well. Trust me. Yeah. And what's so funny is, it started because Pimp posted a screenshot. So, like, Pimp was actually, like, the instrument to just massively tilt Michael Lele. They never came back from that.
Exactly. And it was, like, actually, it was like, oh, no. Pimp, like, 2 hours later, oh, no, sorry, guys. Turned out it wasn't the right account. Oops.
Well, speaking of Flamey, good double kill here. Cease, still alive with the AWP. Could get one more, maybe, but not going to happen. It's easy to take him down instead. The bomb is dropped right in front of the doorway. Slightly awkward position with Seuss right around the corner and Edward quickly closing in. They throw the bomb over and it's just like, what am I supposed to do with that? And AC, he can't get to it either. What is this, Jacob? That was definitely not a smart move. And now it's a 2-on-2 with Edward coming in with a good headshot here. And Fox, well, he's got the tech line out. Flashbang is perfect. And Edward, he can't see anything. Fox might be able to clutch this. Indeed he will. Triple kill and 14 rounds for G2.
Wow, what a clutch from Fox, and I can't believe it. Guardian misses that shot? Unreal. You would think that he would just hit that any day of the week. He knew exactly where Fox was coming from, but not to be. What is to be, however, is Jacob dropping a 30 bomb. So, nicely done. Fox with the 1v2 clutch, and a wallbang on seized from Fox. He keeps on delivering. Which is good. It shows progress. You know, the Portuguese mindset, right? They used to just take. Now, you know, he gives.
I don't even know what that's supposed to be. Oh! Edward almost with the shot through on Rain. Not quite doing enough damage, though. And the money for actually either team. Now we have a bit of a bank on two people, but if they start losing now, then they could end up getting zoned out of the game just because of the economy. That always sucks. Mm-hmm.
Whoa. Okay. Now they rotate back over to B. They really had a focus on mid there. I'm wondering if they got some misinformation as far as a B split or something that was coming in for Na'Vi. But now they consolidate, seized once again with that AWP. Changed up his position. Not as obvious this time. There's the jump. Doesn't realize. Doesn't take the bait. Doesn't take the shot. This could be it. There we go. Gets the flick. Warall would be proud.
Well, Flamey's there to try and back it up a bit. They're playing a 2-on-4 and they should be able to retake this bomb site. G2, they might have to fight a little bit longer. At least the bomb plant here would definitely help them out with the money. Seuss, he's going to go down. That's a random headshot for Mike Lele. Fox covering as well. Flamey, don't peek it. There's no reason to just get everybody in position before you do anything. And I think that's what they're finally going to try and realize. Mike Lele moving close to Edward here. He's got the AK in hand and he's not going to win the fight. So now Fox is in a lot of trouble here.
They've spotted him as well. They know exactly what he's playing from. Hard situation to be in with an AWP as well. Unless you were to just hit like crazy cold zero level headshots, it just wouldn't happen. So, Na'Vi, they're going to even it up. And Anders, we're going the distance. We're going 30 rounds, baby.
I mean, there's no denying that. Double up investment here for Na'Vi. The money for G2, it's just not there.
No, they're going. I mean, are they going for overtime? It seems like it. Big Plays Inc., and I am really surprised to see that G2, they have the self-control not to hit that buy script, you know, just buy whatever you can. No, sir, they are going to play for the long game. And, well, so far it's actually looking all right. Jacob does manage to trade effectively. Then they was that a 3-for-1?
No,
it was a 2-for-1, okay.
It was a 2-for-1, but it was 4 kills long for Guardian. That was very impressive. Yeah, it lined up with the spray, and I think a grenade on top as well, but that was impressive. 15, 14, 30th round coming up, auto-sniper now being picked up as well on the Na'Vi side, including the double up here, so they want to see if they can steal it away in the very last round possible. Fox in the middle, not going to get the shot with the scout, not the AWP. And this is a crazy game right now.
What's really crazy, dude, is double up SCAR 20. This is Na'Vi, like, when Na'Vi are so far ahead, it's like, you know what? What would be better than two ops? Not a third op, Anderson, what you're going to say. A SCAR 20.
I'm all for that. Why not use that money at that point in time?
Guardian needs to get his 30 bomb as well. Just saying, you know, it's unacceptable in a god's eyes that, you know, some mere, like, Norwegian mortal is going to, you know, surpass him. He needs to get some kills here. Three kills in the round. Guardian, perfectly capable of doing it.
Oh, Seuss. That looked like it was a straight headshot, but it just passed him. And, well, Jakim's still going to open up with a good kill here. We could be going to... We haven't had overtime yet, but we could be seeing it right here. They've got the entry frag. They've got a little bit of damage on Edward as well. Looks like they actually want to circle back to the A-bomb side. The fact is, G2 should have won this game quite some time ago. Except they've been really slowed down by Na'Vi.
I would love it for Flamey to, like, wreck them with the Arlo noob just to see all the noobs and get really angry. What's up, son? SCAR 20 here for business! Triple! Oh, baby, give me the quad! Not gonna get it.
It's Edward.
But it was close.
It was so close. It could have definitely been, but he's gonna be now in a 1-on-2 here, trying to see if he can make it back, but he'd have to come up with a huge clutch here. Soon as they realize where he is, he's gonna be in so much trouble. AC in the back lines. Fox as well, he's walking right into a crossfire, and he's not gonna make it out. That's overtime on the first map.
There we go. There we go. He did actually deliver too. Seriously, guys, if you guys get mad about people using the auto sniper, like, you need to learn to play. You're just bad at the game. Like, there are so many ways to counter the auto sniper that, you know, really just don't. Because I've seen, like, I've actually seen, like, you know, some of the hate messages that players get when they use the SCAR 20, right? And people are just, like, sending them, like, hate mail, like, ah, auto noob, ah, I can't believe it, you're garbage, why do you use the auto sniper? It's just like, oh my god, you're so bad, aren't you? Just don't.
Yeah,
just don't. You know, just tame that inside yourself and just work harder. There you go.
It's just one of those things where there's not a lot to do. Oh, and
what?
It's fine, Tim. You can talk.
Yeah, you can talk. What's up? Huh?
Oh.
Well, dude, this is it's intentional, bro. It's all part of the ghetto stream atmosphere.
That's why we call it the ghetto stream, Tim.
Exactly, bro. Tim, you got to realize there's a level to a level to a level here. So, I know, like, Netherlands don't actually have a ghetto. They call that Amsterdam. But still, bro, like, you know.
Oh, God. What is this? All right. We've got people readying up. We've got the countdown going on. I mean, we have, in regulation, 33 kills for Jakim. Admittedly, he slowed down at the end of the game, but that was still a very, very impressive game from him. Guardi nearly catching up, though. We've got the overtime in effect, 16,000, and I think it is... Oh, it's right now MR3, all right. I thought it was MR5 for some reason. AWP on Fox. Double up on the CT side. Guardian being boosted up here.
Indeed. And he's going to go... They didn't really do this in normal time in regulation, so this is interesting. Finally, something changing up here for Na'Vi. CT side, they're going ham. Double op, straight in mid, crossfire set up here. Guardian looking top, C's looking bottom, and it's going to be Zeus to completely and utterly fail a free kill. So, fantastic work there by Zeus, and it's going to open everything up here for G2. Now they can just power up onto the site if they wish. But no, they're smarter than that, Anders. They're going to take their time and make Na'Vi sweat.
Well, Seize is going to try and follow up on it. He's controlling a good angle here, which is definitely very, very important. Going to be an easy kill on Mike Hilele, which brings it back into a 3-on-3. But you're right, that should have been very easy for Seuss then. And I see the whole chat spamming bot, Seuss. So, yeah, Twitch chat is in on it too. Guardian ends up going down. It's Flamey and Seized here in a 2-on-3. And Flamey looking for a way to stop them from crossing. That smoke is going to make it very difficult. He barely tries to... Or barely spots them. If you could have got the killer shot on Rain, that would have actually prevented the bomb from going down. But now Molotov, and they're kind of forced into the smoke. They boost inside it, and they spray over. And they shut down Jake and Rain trying to make it out as well. He's got no idea, and he goes down. And now it's on Fox.
That was so goddamn sexy. You saw it coming from a
mile
away from our
perspective. If he doesn't get the skill crossing, then they defuse the bomb.
There's the flash. He covers it. Oh, he doesn't hit the shot.
Now he's... Yeah.
That's it. It's done. He had one chance. Is he... Yeah, actually, he had literally one chance there. He needed to hit seized. Otherwise, Flamey was going to get up onto that site and get the defuse. What a horrible plant for Fox, actually.
Would you say that opportunity comes only once in your life? Some 8 mile stuff. All right.
Go for it, dude.
No. 16-15.
Let me wipe the spaghetti off your shirt.
No, I prefer the Wu-Tang anyway.
That's right, bro. Seriously.
Seized and Guardian. Even more double up, but I mean, winning around like that, you've got to be confident. And G2. I don't know. I don't know where their minds must be at right now. They were so far ahead in regulation. Mm-hmm. And to now be playing overtime and even losing the first round of overtime, it's got to feel a little bit depressing.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be frustrating. No doubt about it. I mean, especially on their map, if I'm not mistaken, they picked us too. So it's a bit of an issue. Nice shot by Edward, though. Quick flick. Gets the kill onto Rainmon. Well, that's not going to help you when Jacob and Daisy are around. Jacob just lighting him up. Dude, this guy just continues. He's going to get a 40 bomb easy in this overtime. No problem at all. Like, what's he at now, Anders? He was like at 33 or something already in regulation.
35 is what we're at.
It's
definitely possible.
He's still got time.
Well, Seized. I mean, they've got plenty of money here, so they're never really going to run out. But, I mean, at this point, he might as well kind of go for it. There's not much reason not to. Just hope that they make a mistake.
Seized is like, it's time for Siesta, Fox. Oh! Oh, wow. Now Seized is styling.
Very, very good shot here. The bomb is obviously going to explode no matter what happens at this point here. Trying to see if he could maybe just annoy them a little bit, because doing damage to them like economic doesn't really make a difference either. And going into the last round of the first half of overtime, unless the scoreboard is wrong, but I mean it should say 5 out of 10 or 0 out
exactly.
of 10 at the beginning here, so I think it is. And they're buying accordingly. These three AWPs and an auto sniper is just a way of saying we've got so much money, might as well just try and wallbang in the middle with everything that we've got and see what comes out of it. And it's a kill on Flamey. That's an excellent start.
Oh, that's fantastic. Best case scenario there. And they actually... Oh, and then Fox is there to catch Edward, who was really going to try and go ham over it long.
Well, he was peeking with a grenade.
Yeah, what is that? Good. He gets punished. Well, I think Edward is basically like, oh, they're still standing around, you know, like trying to tag through the doors. You know, maybe nobody went long house. I can get in there, try and lay a trap. But one step ahead, G2. One step ahead. And now it's Seized. Taking a dirt nap.
Guardian and Seuss. I mean, this is a quick switch around here. Now you're winning the first round of overtime, but looks like they're about to lose the next two here. A lot of Molotovs in. Seuss. Alright, this is not going to be butt Seuss. This has got to be godlike Seuss at this point here. Getting a headshot first, and that drops the first bomb as well. AC, and that's the last one. Headshot from Seuss. All three kills. And now V, they win 2 out of 3 rounds in the first half of overtime, in spite of a very bad start to this round.
I better see some God Zeus spam in the chat right now, because that was worthy. Nice hold, Zeus. Just single-handedly holding the line for his team. Guardian makes it over the 30 bomb line. There we go. We get some God Zeus in the chat. Thank you very much. Got to look out for him, man. Well, there we go. Na'Vi, they do end up coming out ahead here. 17. The first to 19 is what we're looking at here. They're looking for, rather. We want to see who's going to be able to close out this first map and go on into the second with a map advantage. I think that's pretty much the point here. Right, Anders?
That is the point. That's exactly what's going on. You still got it, Samma.
Okay. Still there. I was worried there for a second,
It has been a slightly long day, actually.
A little bit, but it's all good.
I think we're here around 10, so it's a good 11 hours. And soon.
It's all good, homie. So it's good to have a day like this every now and again, right? Just to, like, refresh. Or it's just like, cast 3 best of 3s. This is how lands used to be, though, Anders, right? Just you and me.
Every
on our
day.
Own. Bootstrap.
Every day. It's true.
PC at our feet. X-Split a running.
That's exactly right. What is getting me really hype is them building the arena in the background. Like, I go back to check every once in, like, every couple of hours, and this place is going to be sick as hell tomorrow. So,
damn straight.
Whatever else you're doing tomorrow, you've got to tune in. There's only going to be one stream tomorrow, so Semler and I will be off the drugs and off the ghetto stream, and we'll be on the main stream. It'll be great. Trust me. Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. Oh.
Jacob, I thought maybe he'd try and push for the smoke. That, or let's try the Molotov. That is actually a thing you could do, because a lot of times someone will be sleeping on the other side. So it's a big risk, but I don't know. Jacob, slightly crazy. Could be the thing.
Oh, he's Norwegian, right? I don't know how that was supposed to work, that joke, but whatever.
Norwegians are definitely crazy.
They are a little crazy.
For real.
I mean.
Crane gonna go down early on now. That opens up a lot of the middle, and Michael Lilly gonna lose that fight as well. They were so ready for him. AC alone in this bomb site with an M4, and there's actually no way to win that. He's just gonna go down. 10 seconds left as well. Bomb will be planted with 5 seconds left. 4 seconds? There we go. And Jacob alone in a 1-on-5. It's a really strong start here for a Na'Vi. If they get one more round, that's it.
Mm-hmm. And they've got a couple chances to do it. So let's see if they don't have an easy round here versus G2, for example. I mean, in the G2, they obviously had 16K starting money, so they can afford to go for a full buy. But Na'Vi, they've got
Look
quad ops and an auto sniper.
Come on, Zeus.
Come on, Zeus. Boom. Bit of a traffic jam there in CT. They're going to sneak their way past, though. And G2 will actually come out ahead. Fox, tired of the shenanigans. He's going to shut Guardian down.
Interesting. And he's still in middle, looking for a bit of a fight, but it's Fox and Michelelli on the other side with a couple of AWPs of their own. And again, you do that when you think you've got the money for it. They would even have the money to go for it again if they wanted to, at least on some of their players here. So, yeah, even if they lose this round, they could still try and just spam up the middle.
Yeah, unfortunately for... Yeah, it didn't work out quite as well as it did for G2 for Na'Vi. Not to say that they're out of it just yet, but Michelele, we'll see if he's quick enough. Nope, doesn't manage to track across to the first man. Instead, he's going to just fumble with Molotov. He was cold. It's cold here in Minsk.
Yeah, need to warm up a little bit. Why everyone is, to be honest. Jacob, and also Fox up here on the bomb side. This could definitely be a really solid defense with Michelele playing on the ramp as well. It is going to be a split right now, and I think the only one who could maybe open up might be Edward. If he picks the right timing to peek against Fox while he's looking catwalk, this may work out. Jacob goes down early on. Now Fox in a bit of an odd position. He's getting some help from Michelele coming in here. Fox picks up the first one, but he goes down. And now V's trying to make it work. Michelele jumping with a no-scope. It's a 2-on-3.
Between Flamey and Zeus, they will be able to plant open. They have some options, but it's not ideal. They're going to stay boxed on this site. They need to find a way to fight the man on cat. There's a smoke to go down. And Rain right on the edge. Michelele going for the peek, attempting the jump shot. But that gives the info. And boom, there's one headshot. Zeus, he delivers. He's going to get the second. Not going to get the third. Michelele stands strong with the CZ-75.
Wow, that was very, very scary for a moment. But it does work out. That makes it 18-17. So either we go into double overtime or... It's going to be Na'Vi to run away with it just at the end here. They go for the double AWP. Flamey, you've got plenty of money. There's an auto sniper as well, and a lot more AWPs. There we go. Wall bang that middle, but there's one on AC as well. Are they going to take this fight? This is going to be hilarious, isn't it?
Let's do it. Let's do it. Boom. Okay, one shot on the Rain. Are we going to get the follow-up from Michelele? Is Michelele going to be brave enough? There are two people waiting, although they are getting in, well, a little on top of each other. It's Zeus! No, that was over on B-side. That was over on B-side.
Oh, was it? Damn, I didn't see. I was so excited. I was so sure it was going to be the case.
He has no idea that Rain is so low. Rain has only got the 7 HP.
Oh,
what?
Wow.
What?
What? What is going on? Edward shutting down Jacob and Zeus. Being caught hacking live on stream.
Absolutely. This is what happens when you're an omniscient being, you know? This is why he doesn't have to worry about VAC or anything like that, right? You know, it's the hacks aren't in-game. He just knows. Now, that's what happens when you're God.
They're all in his mind. I love it how everyone's saying fake VAC in the chat, and then it goes right into Seuss just going nuts.
Oh, my God, dude. That was sick.
Well, Michelele and Fox, it's 2-on-4 at the moment, and... It looks like it's going to be Na'Vi stealing it away at the end here, unless the double AWP setup could really play out here. Michelele, now is the time to shine. They're going to come through the smoke right behind him, and he can't see a thing. Flamey takes one. A nice shot from Fox here, but bomb will be planted, and he's going to have to go for the ace clutch here.
Let's see it. Fox, if ever there was a time for you to go legend, it's not now, because Edward is not interested. 19-17, Na'Vi pick up the first map here on Dust2. It was G2's map, so things not going according to plan here for the mix.